Very morning to one and all. We have started the lesson number 7, that is Amazing Animal. This lesson is a little bit vast, so we are going to learn this step by step. In the last previous video, we have learned the habitat, what is meant by the habitat. Then we have learned about the adaptations. Then we have learned about the food feeding habit about the animals. Yes or no? In today's video, we are going to discuss about the organ of breathing. We are going to discuss about the organ of breathing. Now, the animals which are found in the different types of a habitat, they have to for the survival, they have to breathe, right? To where the animals which lives in the different types of the habitat, the most important thing is the breathing. Yes or no? So now that we can find the different animals living in a different habitat, for example, the animals living on the land, the animals which are living in the ocean or in the river, or the animals which are flying in the air, according to that they have to develop their breathing habit too. Now the animals, if you will see, the animals are mainly classified into two types, that is unicellular and multicellular. Now what is this unicellular? See, animals which have only one cell, the animals which have only one cell, they are called as a unicellular organism. Means what? The single cell can function the different types of activity. The single cell can do all the activities which are done by the multiple cells. Now, for example, there are some organisms, for example, amoeba and paramecium. These two organisms, these are very tiny organisms which are made up of single cell. So that single cell can perform all the activities. For example, breathing can be done by the that particular one cell, then excretion is done by that particular only one cell. The single cell can perform this activity. So such animals are called as a unicellular organism. And the animals which have the multicells, means more than one cell, they are called as a multicellular organism. The multicellular organism means the animals which have the number of cells to do the different types of function, they are called as a multicellular organism. For example, birds, tiger, lion, human beings comes under the multicellular organism. The unicellular organisms are the amoeba and paramecium, which have a single cell which can perform all the activities. Now, the breathing is done by this kind of unicellular organism, that is amoeba and paramecium. The breathing is done by its body surface. Are you getting? Then the next type of the organism we are going to learn about, multicellular organism, which consists of number of cells. It comes insect, aquatic animals, terrestrial animals comes under the multicellular organism. Now insects, they have multicellular organism. Now the animals such as insects, such as grasshopper, which breathe, they have a very tiny hose that is called as a spiracles. They have a tiny hose that is called as a spiracles. The air enters through the, they have a tiny hole that is called as a spiracles. The air enters through these spiracles. And move through the tube called as a breathing tube. The air enters through these tiny holes and move to the whole body by the tube that is called as a breathing tube. This is how the breathing is done by the grasshopper. Then the next is the animals which are found in the water. How do they breathe? See, they take the oxygen which is dissolved in water. They are also called as an aquatic animals. The animals which lives in the water, they are called as an aquatic animals. They take the oxygen which is dissolved in water. they have a organ that is called as a gills. Now the fishes such as even fishes, crab take in the oxygen through the mouth, and this the water is entered through this mouth and the water is removed by the gills, and the air which is there, the oxygen is passed through the all the parts of the body, and exhale of the carbon dioxide is taken by the gills. The carbon dioxide is given out by the gills. Are you getting? So this is how the animals in the water can breathe. But there are some animals which lives in the water. They lives in the water, but they take the oxygen which is by the through lungs. For example, if you will see the dolphins, well, also they breathe through the lungs. They lives in the water, but they breathe through lungs. So you can see the dolphins and whales are coming out of the water in for a second, and they take the oxygen and go deep into the water or in the ocean. They take, why do they come out? To take a oxygen. You can see the dolphin, whales, they are coming out. Why is it so? To take an oxygen, So they breathe through lungs. Then the next is the animals which lives in the soil. Now there are some animals which lives in the soil. For example, the earthworm. How do they breathe? They breathe through the moist skin. The earthworm breathe through its moist skin. Are you getting this? Now there are some animals which lives in the water as well as in the on the land. Which are they? Can you just tell me? In the last video I have told one example that animals, there is one animal which lives in the water and also on the land. They are called as an amphibian animals. For example, frog. Frog lives in water as well as on land. But when it is on the land, it breathes through the lungs. The animals which lives on the land, they breathe through the lungs. Are you getting? So they, when it is on the land, the frog, when it is on the land, it breathes through the lung. And the when it is in the water, it breathes through its moist skin. Are you getting? Now the adult. Now see, you can see that there is a different animals which are found on the land also. That is, for example, the birds. We, the human being, we breathe all through the lungs. We take in the oxygen. The air is taken from the nostril. The air enters through the nostril and reaches through the all the parts of the body, and we give out carbon dioxide. So the breathing process is done by the lungs. Are you getting this? So today I hope you have understood the concept of organ of breathing. The different animals breathe through the different parts of the body according to the habitat where they live. Are you getting this? So I hope you have understood it. So read the concept of organ of breathing. Just write the difficult words and in your science notebook till the point which I have taught. Thank you.